Hi, Lauren here. I wanted to share a story with you that's really close to my heart. You see, when I was growing up, my dad was always working, providing for our family. He'd leave for work before we got up for school, and he'd get home and eat dinner, and then be back on his laptop doing more work. One day at school, I had a project I had to do, which was to make a family shield, and we had to put a symbol for each family member on that shield. And for my dad, I put a picture of a mobile phone because he was always on the phone to work. My mum was very upset by this, but it was the truth. And my dad always working caused a lot of tension in our family, and I didn't like it. And at that point in time, I made a promise to myself I'd never be like this. I'd never have work take over my life. Yet 15 years later, I found myself pretty much in a similar situation. My life on the outside looked nice and shiny. I had a good job, a good career, a boyfriend, a house on the way, a pretty good life. I couldn't really complain. But there was a bit of a gap. On the inside, I was in turmoil. I was struggling to keep up with everything. Responsibility was taking over. I was struggling to have time to practice yoga, which is the one thing that made me feel a lot better about myself in life. And so everything was just all getting a bit too much. Something had to give, like I couldn't go on like this. And I realized, I thought back to that time where I made that promise to myself that I'd never be busy and always working like that. Something really had to change. And so I took some time to think about what could I really do differently? Like what was wrong? What had to change? Why was I like this? And the thing is, I realized that like I was doing what was expected of me and going through the motions, and I hadn't really ever backed myself completely. The thing I'd never done was to back myself completely and go, I'm gonna go all in and go after whatever I wanted, no matter what anyone else thought. And so that's what I decided to do. I was like, that's the change I'm gonna make, and I'll set that intention and then find a way, a strategy to implement that. But you know, it wasn't really that simple. A real problem came up. The thing is when you're used to doing what's expected of you, you're used to pleasing other people, it's a really tough thing to go against the grain to change that. So, you know, if you're anything like me, you've been brought up to be a good girl, to have, you know, to get good grades in school and uni, and then have your career and move up the ladder and get the husband and the house and have a baby and all those kinds of things. And if you go against the grooved track of where you're meant to be going, you go against the grain, a lot of resistance comes up and it's quite challenging, and you've got to have a strong belief in yourself to get through that. The people around you kind of want you to do what is expected of you. The environment sets you up for that. And your subconscious mind is also programmed for that. So that's what's familiar to you. And if you go against that, it feels it's unsafe. So it can be really tough. But the thing is, having come out the other side now, is I can say that it's really worthwhile. Like, cracking that is really worth it, to be able to go after the life you really want. Instead of worrying and wasting your precious time, like worrying about the ways you're inadequate or how things don't stack up, then you can turn things around to actually focus on enjoying your life and creating the life you want, and how focusing on how you can get more enjoyment out of your own life. It really makes a huge difference to give yourself permission to write your own story, to have your own back, to really be in your own corner, and that can really transform your life. And the reason I tell this story is because I see so many other women struggling with these kinds of things, and I really want to share my story and get that out there so that they can see that there's a way you can overcome this, and simple strategies and steps you can put in place to turn things around. And that's why I've developed a free guide for women, the guide from surviving to thriving, and how you can rediscover your sparkle. So if you've ever felt any of these issues or struggled with anything like this, like what I have, I'd love you to click the link below and check it out and let me know how you go with it and how you might make some changes in your life. So thanks so much for listening. I hope you have a really great day, and I'll talk to you soon.